let's keep the theme going as at this Friday afternoon market recap. I will say in a couple of minutes time, I will be sitting down to record this weekend Pivot Point Pro Analysis Workshop. So that will and should be up online in the next 6 hours or so. That is going to be a recorded class, pardon me, as it is each and every week. And again, we're going to go over in more depth, of course, some of the analysis, which I am very much going to briefly walk you through at the moment. So again, going back into, all right, the theme that we've been talking about over the past number of weeks, if I can bring up the right template on my screen, let me begin. Let me ask you the question. Can you see a significant or a material change in that of the ADX indicator that we have been referencing over the past number of weeks? And I'll put a little bit of a question mark on my screen at the moment. I hope the answer to that question is yes, you can see a difference. What I'm trying to do is just remove essentially that of the CCI indicator. Now you can see with a little bit more sort of contrast the movement or the turn down in the ADX. If you cannot see that, I'm trying to illustrate it for you. But we picked up on this about mid-week. We were expecting a little bit of volatility either to show up on Thursday, if not potentially during today's session. We started to see a little bit as at Thursday, but it looks as though today we're starting to see that material, or what appears to be a material, break to the downside. As I said, I'm going to recap this in much more detail. We have also got some important leading, okay, economic updates or indicators that have been released during the week, which are very much concerning. They are sort of deteriorating a little bit faster than what we originally expected. Again, it doesn't really change our longer term outlook on the overall market structure or the cycle, at least as it's sort of where we are in 2020. But we did see a material sort of turn down and at least the leading indicators, which again, I will be recapping when I sit down and record this weekend's pro. But really what we have here on the NASDAQ is that of an outside day engulfing Morabozu candlestick. This was after some of the hangman types of candlesticks that we have presented. Also pseudo types of dragonfly dojis as well. We've got some sort of pseudo shooting star candlesticks as well. Another hangman candlestick leading into this, or at least today's outside day engulfing candlestick, down 88 points. We did close down close to 1%, a little bit under 1%. But really what you need to take away is not necessarily today's candlestick or the point differential close. What you should be thinking about is, what does this mean in terms of the ADX? If you go back, and even if you go back on a weekly chart as well, which at this particular point, closing up Friday, it still isn't done. What you can at least distinguish is that this is, again, extremely elevated on the weekly time frame, but when that turns down in combination with the turndown that we have seen as of this week on the daily settings of the ADX, bad things generally happen for the market. And really, it has been quite a slow, at least, re-entry back into the calendar year of 2020 after the very fast finish that we had into the end of 2019. Largely, we've just stayed on the sidelines. We've just sort of been sitting on our hands. We did go long, obviously, the VIX. You can go back and have a look at that update. It spiked today. You can see on my screen at the moment, it closed at 14.56, all right? But during the day session, it was up at 16. If we see, again, a continued pullback in the markets, you're going to see the VIX continue to spike as well. Speak more about that in this weekend's recap. However, going back into the NASDAQ, I just wanted to show you that this is the first time whereby we're actually coming back to retest the 10 and what looks to be more of a definitive retest since the period at the beginning of December over here, where we briefly sort of closed below that of the 10 and the 20. I think that this particular, right, test of the 10 is not only going to result in the break of the 10, also the breaking of the 20, but more or less an absolute minimum coming back down to retest this rising 50 exponential moving average. But depending on that ADX indicator, and of course, if you have a look at these oscillators as well, turning down, have a look at this, RSI is just pushing out of overbought. The MACD is only just preparing to cross down. Have a look at this in terms of net momentum. You can see that the histogram bar is about to push into the negative territory. Stochastics, which has been elevated for about a month and a half, it is starting to turn down as well. Or even if you wanted to go back to late October, November, as this trend has broken out, we have remained in overbought territory, really boarding on about really 3 months. If you wanted to go back to the midpoint of October here, to the midpoint in January, that is roughly 3 months. All of these signals right now are really blending into volatility. And that's why essentially we are long the VIX at this particular time. But the ADX, however, is sharply turning down. So those warning signals mixed with today's candlestick, now I've just flicked on over into the Dow Jones Industrial Average. Pay attention to the outside day candlestick. It didn't close down as much as the S&P and the NASDAQ. Down 170 points, however, but what we have been sort of talking about is potentially that of a very pseudo sort of a light double top, or at least the ending of this intermediate trend, the exhaustion of this momentum move to the upside. There's a very good chance that this is now the ending of the sentence. So if you wanted to think about the Fibonacci retracements, you've got the beginning of the sentence over here, you've got the closing of the sentence, or the sort of the finishing conclusion to the paragraph itself, which is the narrative of this market move. If you want to go back and have a look at the Fibonacci retracements, that's something that we're going to do in this class, which is going to give us hopefully a confluence of support where X marks the spot as to sort of a target as to where this intermediate pullback is going to run to. So again, volatility is only just starting to spike. Pay attention to this also, the S&P 500, the ADX. What I'll do, I'll try and remove or at least move down the CCI so you can get a better look at the turndown in the ADX, a very aggressive turndown. Very rarely, again, do you see the S&P 500 up at these extremes as to where we have currently been. In fact, it's only been this over, sort of overstrung. Back in the period of October 2018, this was during the meltdown. And then, of course, prior to that, you have to go all the way back to January of 2018 as well. On both of these occasions, it didn't end well for the market. So again, some warnings or additional warnings there. I've gone through and recapped this, but this looks to be the beginning of, you know, potentially a little bit of a volatile period whereby a lot of people are going to begin talking about recessionary fears, all sorts of things which are going to help spruik the market into some form of a retracement, upon which we're just going to simply look to buy this market at discounted prices. We're still not bearish on the market. We're still very much heavily bullish. But again, just the candlestick alone mixed with the ADX and potentially the breaking of the rising exponential moving averages, right, based on the S&P 500 closing down close to 1% today, down 30 points, mixed with the array of candlesticks over the past week or so, it's just got sort of potentially bad things written on price behavior over the next couple of weeks, if not 1 to 2 months. Right, so we're in front of this, we're front running the volatility. And if you're not taking equity trades, I congratulate you for that. The reason is because a lot of these gains over here are going to be given back very, very quickly. In fact, just a good example of this is if you take into consideration the closing price, obviously as to where we were on Friday, it's really just negated that of Thursday, Wednesday, obviously Tuesday of this week. Then you have to go back to Friday and Thursday of last week, which takes us back to the 16th of January. Very quickly, we could see pretty much the year-to-date returns of this market wiped out in the space of two sessions, if not maybe three sessions as well. All right, so that's the reality that we're operating in. A lot of people, unfortunately, they give into the temptation of the slow grind higher right at the very end of that intermediate trend whereby they feel as though there's no risk left in the market. However, unfortunately for them, they're not really understanding the picture, and it's really the most risky time to be actually be going long. You want to be going long as everyone else is actually selling their positions in fear. So we'll wait for that time to come, and we'll look to go obviously on the opposite side of that trade. In the meantime, however, we're going to go through a pretty comprehensive recap of our top 12 individual trade list. The reason for this is because some have actually rotated through earnings, but there are also a couple of market leaders set to report this coming week now. Okay, so I'll leave that for that analysis class as well. Enjoy your weekend, everyone. As I said, I'm going to sit down right now and begin recording Pivot Point Pro. Sign up, have a look into that class. I'm sure you'll learn a thing or two, not only this week, but for an extended period. And also just in terms of the market cycle, I think it is very much in your best interest to be on the same page as to why and to why not you should be looking to trade long and short at this particular time. And then obviously the changing of the guide when you move from the macro expansion into that of the cyclical downtrend, right? Or into that the contraction, i.e. the recession, which is on sort of the horizon. It's not here yet, but again, looking at this point into 2021. All right, so we'll talk about that as well. All the best, everyone. It's James signing off on behalf of Pivot Point Trading. Pardon me. Farewell.